Hello everyone and welcome back to another BCP library video. My name is Katy and today I'm going to show you how you can make these really cool library card holders, and this is to celebrate Libraries Week, so you might notice a few extra videos on the BCP Libraries playlist because of this. So what you need for these card holders is some card. If you don't have card, you can use some cereal packaging and some paper, pencil and ruler, scissors and glue, colouring pens, pencils, some stickers, googly eyes, all those kind of little odds and ends of craft bits that you might have at home, and of course your library card. So first of all, I'm going to show you how to make the basic card holder, just the basic rectangle. So I started off by measuring the library card, and a library card is the same size as a standard card, and it is roughly around about 8 to 9 centimeters by 6 centimeters, or 5.5, just roughly. It doesn't really matter because we need to make the rectangles bigger than the card. So what I'm doing is first of all doing a 10 centimeter by 8 centimeter rectangle, and then measuring out an 8 centimeter by 8 centimeter square, and this will make the pocket for our library card. And the reason is we're making it a little bit bigger is because we're going to be gluing around the edges, so that will make the hole where you put the card in smaller, but this will make it fit quite nicely. So those are the rough measurements. So you just need to take your pencil and ruler and draw those rectangle and a square like I'm doing here, and just press quite lightly. You don't want the lines to show when you have cut them out, but I pressed a little bit harder just so you could see on camera. So when you have drawn those, you just need to cut them out like I'm doing here, and then you need to take the smaller square and put it on top of the rectangle, and you can see it is that little bit smaller, so you'll be able to get your card out. And then you need to take your glue stick, and just a normal Pritt stick, glue stick is absolutely fine, and you just need to glue on three sides, so the bottom and along the right side and the left side. And you don't want to use the top side because you need to get your card into the pocket. So you just need to press it down like that, and then you can decorate it how you like. I've just written my name on it and just added a few stamps. This is just the basic card shape, and you can decorate yours however you want to. And then through the opening, the side that we didn't glue, you can place your library card. So that is how to do a basic card holder. So I'm now going to do a tiger, and first of all we have our 10 by 8 centimeters and our 8 by 8 centimeters already drawn out, and then I rounded off the top to make a head and then added some ears, and I'm also adding some googly eyes, but if you don't have any googly eyes you can just draw yours on, that's absolutely fine. So I've drawn the head above the square that we had before, and I've added some stripes like that, and I'm just colouring in the tiger's belly and feet, and I've drawn the feet and the belly on the smaller square, and I'm just colouring in the ears. And once I had coloured it in, I then cut it out like before, exactly the same as before, but we're just cutting all the way around rather than cutting out the rectangle. So again, we need to glue it on, glue down the three of the sides of the square onto the rectangle. So we want to do the bottom, the right side and the left side, but we don't put any glue on the top because we want to get our library card into the card holder. And there we go, we just stick it down and make sure it dries nicely. And I also added a little tail to mine. I just cut out an extra piece of orange card and added some stripes and made a tail, and there is the finished one. So now we're going to make a monster, and again we have our 10 centimeter by 8 centimeter rectangle and an 8 by 8 centimeter rectangle drawn out, and then I've drawn the monster's head like I did before with the tiger on top, added three googly eyes this time because our monster has three eyes, then I'm just adding some spots to the monster, and then I cut it out again, and before we stick it down, I'm just cutting out some white triangles, and these will be the teeth of our monster. And what we are going to do is we're going to cut them out, and then we're going to stick them to the back of the square. So we need to turn the square around once we've cut out our teeth. Turn the square around like this and use some Pritt stick again, or some glue stick, and just put some glue along the top and then stick the teeth behind like this. And then we are ready to stick the three sides of our square onto our rectangle piece, and you need to glue all the way down the right, bottom and left. And I've also added a couple of little arms like this, just to make it that little bit more 3D and that little bit more scary, if you like, because it's a scary monster and he's going to eat your library card. And I've also added a piece of felt, pink felt, to put on, because that makes a nice tongue. But it's totally up to you. Maybe you want to do more eyes, more teeth, different shapes. You can experiment and make your monster how you want to. And then we just pop the library card in like that. And finally, I have this unicorn design, and again, I've got my 10x8 rectangle where I've added a head on top. I added a semicircle like the other two, and then triangles for the ears. I added a unicorn horn, and I'm colouring in the mane with a rainbow pencil, but you can colour it in whatever colours you like. And I also use some sparkly gel pen as well, and I'm just drawing a tail here that I'm going to stick on to the back when I have finished. And yeah, I did our eyes closed because I thought that would be a little bit cuter, but you can do open eyes, you can add googly eyes, it is totally up to you. These are your designs, these are just some ideas that you can follow if you want to. So there we go, it's cut out and I've stuck down the square, again, glued along the left, the bottom and the right of the square, and added the tail. And now I'm just adding a few sequins onto the body because unicorns are quite sparkly, so that's what I'm doing. I'm just adding a few sequins. But you can add whatever you like. Maybe you have some feathers, some stickers, it's totally up to you. And once I'd done, I added a bit of the pink felt to the bottom as well, just to give it that little bit more texture. And as you can see, it's a very sparkly unicorn. And I'm just going to pop the library card in like that. And there we have our unicorn library card holder. So these are my three designs, and if you don't have a library card yet, you can go and get your very own library card from any of the BCP libraries. Just take a grown-up with you and we will be able to sign you up, and you can start borrowing books and reading them at home. But these are my library card designs. You can make whatever you want to. These are just some ideas. Maybe you can make your favourite animal, your favourite book character, or you just want to decorate it in a very funky way. It is totally up to you. These are your designs. These are just some ideas to help you. So do have a look out on the BCP YouTube channel for the rest of the week for some more Libraries Week videos. We have quite a lot of story times for you. And that is all for this video, and it's your turn to get creative and make your very own library card holder.